I love it when things pop out when you're reading scripture that you notice that you'd never noticed before. And such is the case today in my reading in Numbers 34, 5 and 6 and Mark chapter 11, and especially in Mark chapter 11, verses 12, 13 and 14. A little bit longer reading, but boy, there's some really cool stuff here. Now the next day when they had come from Bethany, he was hungry, and seeing from afar a fig having leaves, he went to see if perhaps he would find something on it. When he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. In response, Jesus said to it, "Let no one eat from you ever again." And his disciples heard it. Well, I guess one of the first things that just occurred to me now is there's some strange stuff here when you read this, but one of the stranger things, I guess, is that he spoke to the fig tree, kind of an interesting thing. But the whole thing of it is it's only strange if you think Jesus just did random things. He didn't then, and he doesn't now. So when what is all this about? You look at that and you wonder. I saw something, as I said, that I had never seen before in verse 13, the last part. It was not the season for figs. Jesus wasn't just cursing the tree because it didn't have any figs on it when he was hungry as sort of a some kind of a revenge or an outburst of passion because he was hungry and he was not able to satisfy his hunger with some figs. Not at all. He had a purpose. And as I pondered that, what that purpose might be, the realization dawned on me that it was that this too was a part of the lesson that he was teaching the disciples and us here. It was not the season for figs, just as no figs was a sign of what was taking place in Israel. It was not the time, just as it was not his time at the wedding of Cana of Galilee. It was to show the disciples and to show us the place of in history that Israel plays. Their position, their activity on God's prophetic calendar is important for us to consider. And the whole thing of it was is that went right over the disciples' heads. They just didn't get it. Just as today, many people don't get it. And particularly, I think of that of those who are of the persuasion of the replacement theology, that is that the church has replaced Israel and Israel is no more important than that. Israel is the prophetic cog in God's timetable, and we have to pay attention to her in order to fully understand the signs of the time. So God is not through with Israel. You can, as you read through the prophecies of the Old Testament, as you read the New Testament and really meditate and think about it, you have to come to the conclusion that God's not done with her yet. And so we see her playing this vital role in this drama on the stage, that she is never going to be off the stage, as it were. So we have to pay attention to her. It wasn't time for Israel to be on the stage at that point, as the main role player in God's drama, of the drama of his revelation. But the time will come when once again Israel will be back on stage, front and center. And actually the timetable or the clock began ticking on May 14th, 1948, when Israel once again was restored to national prominence, when she stepped onto the stage as a nation once again. And then again in 1967, when she retook Jerusalem. So those are all important events that place her prominently in the whole picture and what God is doing. And so as I thought about that, I thought, well, the clock is ticking. Tick, tock, tick, tock. So we have to pay attention. The time is getting soon. The time is getting closer, and Jesus is going to return soon. So keep your eyes on Israel. And as you do, look up, for he's returning soon. Amen. May the Lord richly bless you today.